Hello everyone, this is Rick with Cybermedics, and we're here today to talk about the YubiKey. In particular, the applications that make the YubiKey useful. But before we do that, if you're not familiar with YubiKeys or hardware security keys and wondering whether you really need one, I recommend you click on our previous video above, which explains adding additional protection to your accounts through a security key. Once you've determined you need a key, you will have to download the YubiKey Key Manager from Yubico and plug in your key to your computing device. And when you do that, you'll see there's a slot 1 and a slot 2. And behind these slots is a configuration button. And when you click the configuration button, you'll see multiple configurations for different types of authentication capabilities. Click the video above if you want to get into the details on the challenge response, the hash-based one-time passwords, and static password. We also cover the OTP, which is the FIDO2 configuration, in that video. Typically, that is programmed for slot 1, where you short touch the key less than 2 seconds, and it sends back a cryptographic response to authenticate you to your service provider. All right, now we're going to go on to slot 1. Remember earlier in the video I discussed slot 1 is typically for FIDO2 applications, short touch to authenticate. We're going to go in and break this and then show you how to reconfigure it. So I'm also calling up the authenticator app because I want you to see what effect or no effect that it has on your time-based one-time passcodes in the authenticator app. We're going to click delete and then we're going to say yes. Now you can see now the slot is empty. We're going to remove the key. We're going to reinsert the key. And you see this key has been acknowledged. And over here on Authenticator, it says no accounts. Well, if you pull the key out again and put the key back in again, you can see the accounts came back. That's because it just needed to reinitialize. It has no effect. Deleting the OTP over here has no effect on your Authenticator application accounts. Let's go through here the application OTP. Now you can see this slot is empty. Okay. Now let's see what effect it had on the previously credentialed accounts with this slot 1. So go into Yahoo, and when I authenticated with that key where the OTP on slot 1 had been removed, it asked me for the PIN. Well, I hadn't changed the PIN, so I put in the PIN. And I said, okay. And it said, touch your key, touch the key, and it logs into the account, which I thought was a little strange because I would have thought deleting the OTP in slot 1, which is what you have to touch in order to authenticate to the account, it would break it. But it didn't break it on Yahoo. However, it was only on Yahoo. Every other account did not work once the OTP was removed. So, slot 1 is empty. Now let's talk about how to reconfigure it. So you go configure, and we're in slot 1, OTP, next. You can say use the serial number, and then you say generate a private ID, and you generate a secret key. And I've just masked these out for security purposes. And then you click upload, and then you click finish, and it failed. And the reason it failed is because I had already used this key previously with the serial number. So what you have to do is you have to come in here, and this is from YubiKey, and see that it says the upload failed because it had already previously been used, and it tells you the details on what can be in that box for it to be uploaded to their cloud service. So we go in here and I just change the last character of this. Instead of saying use serial, upload, finish. And it says, do you want to override it? You say yes. And then it's going to take you to this website for uploading the key. You say, I'm not a robot. You click upload. And it's going to say invalid because I did not short press the key to generate an OTP. Once you short press to generate an OTP, now you can click upload. and it will upload the key and show you whether it was successful. If you want to try it out, you just click try it out, short press the key, and it comes back and it says the OTP key is valid. Let's go back into the app and show you the slot is configured. So we reconfigured the OTP. Let me know if you have any questions or comments below. Hope you will consider subscribing and have a great and wonderful hack-free day.